Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Once again, I welcome you to the Sri Chandra's Distance Learning Program. Dear Semester 1 students, in our last class, we had taken the introduction of syllabus. And also, we had a discussion about the paper pattern as well. Okay. So the paper pattern was very simple. In section A, they will give 6 questions. Out of 6, you have to answer 4 questions. Carries 20 marks. Each carries 5 marks. And in section B, long answer type questions, they will give you 4 questions with internal choice. Each carries 15 marks. 15 into 4 is equal to 60 marks. 60 marks paper for long answer questions and 20 marks paper for short answer questions. In this way, the external exam paper, question paper made of 80 marks. Remaining 20 marks is for internal exam. You will have one internal exam carries 15 marks and 5 marks for project. In this way, the paper will be of 100 marks. In our last class, we took the introduction to the syllabus. Inshallah, today we will start with the easiest topic, that is grammar. We will begin from the grammar. We have grammar in unit number 3. Okay. Unit first, unit second, unit third, and unit fourth. So we will start with the grammar because we will go from easy to the hard, from easiest to the toughest. Okay. Bismillahir Rahman Rahim. Bismillahir Rahman Nir Rahim. In the name of Allah. In the name of Allah, the most gracious, the most gracious, the most merciful. In the name of Allah, the most gracious, the most merciful. Here we will start. Unit 3, unit 3rd belongs to grammar. Lesson number 1. Lesson number 1 is Al-Qawaid. Al-Qawaidu. The first lesson is Al-Kalimatu. Wa aqsamuha. Al-kalimatu wa aqsamuha. It means word and its kinds. Word and its kinds. Okay. We will discuss this topic in detail, inshallah. Azza wa jal. Here, every language based on a set of letters. Each language has set of letters. Like in English, we have 26 letters. In Arabic, we have 29 letters. So for those 29 letters, with those 29 letters, we can form words. Whatever we speak, That will be a word. Okay. Every language has a set of letters, the collection of those letters known as alphabet. Okay. But here, Al-Kalimatu Tatarakkabu Minal Huruf. Kalima is made from the letters. Okay. What is Al-Kalimatu? Kalima is a word which comes out from our mouth. Speech, whatever we say, whatever we talk, whatever we speak, that is a kalima. Okay, waqsamuha and its kinds. We will study about al-kalimatu. What is al-kalimatu? Al-kalimatu tatarakkabu min al-huruf. Kalima form. Kalima is formed from the letters. Kalima can be of a single letter. Okay. Min al-hurufil hijaiyati tatarakkabul kalimat. Kalimat means words are made from the letters. Okay. But word must having some sense, some meaning. If the word has no meaning, then that word would not be considered as a word, not as a kalima. Kalima means kalima can be a single letter word. Okay. Kalima can be a double letter word. Kalima can be a three letter word. Kalima can be a four letter word. Kalima can be a five letter word. Kalima can be a six letter word. And kalima can be a seven letter word. In Arabic, there is no kalima, no word more than seven letters. There is no word more than seven letters. Okay. In Arabic, we have kalima of seven letters word, maximum up to seven letters word. In English, they have more than seven letters as well. But in Arabic, we have seven letters word kalima. Okay, seven letters kalima. So, we will discuss about what is kalima. Kalima means word. Okay, kalima means word. But basically it is a group of letters which give some meaning. Kalima means a group of letters which give some meaning known as kalima. For example, as I told you before, that kalima can be a single letter word like wow. Single letter word, wow. It means and. Don't notice on the English word. English word carries three letters. A, and, A, and, A, N, D, and. Okay, here wow. Wow is a single letter word in Arabic. Wow, and. And it is also used for to take oath. Like in the Quran, Allah says, wal asr, by the period and time. So, kalima is a one letter word. And one letter word like B, which means with. Don't say in English, what is the meaning of B? B means with. But in Arabic, it is a single letter word. As I told you, kalima can be a single letter word. Kalima can be a double letter word, triple letter word, and fourfold letter word, five letters word, six letters word, and seven letters word. Not more than seven letters kalima is there in Arabic. Okay. It is a single letter word. Wa, B, and A. This means is, are, am. Has, had, have. Okay. Was, were. In this short word, a, this translation can be done. Is, are, am, has, had, have, was, were, and do, did, and does. Okay. Do, this, did, does. In this single letter word, these translations can be done according to the context. According to the context, we can translate A as these words. Is, are, am, has, had, have, was, were, do, did, does. Okay. According to the context, we used to change the meaning of A. Okay. A single letter word. I am giving the examples of single letter word kalima. One letter word kalima. One letter. Vav is one letter. Ba is one letter. A is one letter. One letter word kalima it is. And more, many more. We have another word li. Li, which means for or belongs. It is also a single letter word. In English also we have single letter words. But like in English we have single letter word like I, man, I am, I, single letter word. And indefinite article A is a single letter word. Okay. And ka means like, or ka means your as well. If according to the context, ka means like, similar. So these are the examples of single letter word. What is the definition of kalima? Al kalimatu, it is a word made of letters. Okay, it is a word made of letters which give some meaning, or we can say a group of letters which give some meaning, known as al kalimatu. Got it? As I told you, kalima can be of single letter word. Okay, like we took five examples: wa, and, bi, with, li, for, a means all these translation can be done in this word. A, ka means like, and your. Now we will take the example of two letter words. Okay, two letters word. If you want to take the snap or screenshot of this, you may take it. Then we will take the example of two letters word. Got it? Now we will pay a look towards the two letter word in Arabic. In Arabic, two letter word like we have min, which means from. Two letter word, mim and noon, two letter word, min, from. Two letter word like fi, in. And two letter word like an, from or with. Okay, about. An means from or about. Two letter words like we have hal. In hal also many translations can be done, like is, are, I am, does, do, did, and has, have, had, and so on. You see, it is a question tag. We used to ask question with the help of this word hal. It is a two letter word, and translation can be done in this way: is, are, am, does, do, did, has, have, had, and so on, etc. So according to the context we will take any of these translation, like was, were, and so on. Got it? These are the examples of two letter word, two letter or two letter kalima in Arabic. Got it? You may grab the screenshot, then I will rub it, then we will take three letters example, three letter kalima example. In Arabic, kalima can be of three letters as well. For example, we have darsun, lesson, qalamun, pen. Okay, a lesson, a pen, and kalima can be of three letters in Arabic, like kalbun, a dog, kutta. Okay, kalbun, a dog. and deacon, deacon, a cop. Okay, these are the examples of three-letter kalima in Arabic: darsun, qalamun, kalbun, and deacon. A lesson, a pen, a dog, and a cock. Okay. Write it down or take the screenshot. I will rub the board. Then we will go towards four-letter word in Arabic. Four-letter word in Arabic. Okay. We will take the examples of four-letter word in Arabic. Four-letter word like we have kaf ta alif ba kitabun. Kaf ta alif ba kitabun, a book. This is also a kalima made of four letters, kitabun. And masjidun, masjidun, a masjid. Okay, masjid, kitabun, masjidun. And as we took the example of dog, if we want to say dogs, then it will become kilabun, kilabun, dogs. Okay, and one more example we will take, like jadwalu, jadwalu, jadwalun, jadwalun means schedule. Schedule, jadwalun, schedule, schedule. Got it? Then we will discuss about the kalima of five letters. Five letter kalima. We will take the examples of five letter kalima. Five letter kalima like we have muhadirun, muhadirun, lecturer, muhazir, lecturer. Okay, like we take the example of masjid. If we want to say many masjids, then we will say masajidu, five letter word, masajidu, masjids, many masjids. Okay, masajidu, five letter word it is. And five letter word like muhandisun, muhandisun, engineer, engineer. And we have safarjal, it is given here, safarjal. Safarjal is a type of fruit which in English it is called as quince. Quince, okay. Safarjal. Safarjal, Q-U-N-I-C, quince. Safarjal is a type of fruit. Safarjal. Lun. Muhazirun, lecturer, masajidu, masjid, muhandisun, engineer, safarjal, quince, a type of a fruit. Here, now you could understand that these are the examples of five-letter kalima. Okay. Now we will take the examples of six-letter kalima. Six-letter kalima. Six-letter kalima like zafran, zafranun, zafran, saffron. Saffron we say in English, saffron. Zafran jise hum kehte hain, zafran. And other word is inshirah, inshirahun, inshirah means opening up, opening up, inshirah, opening up. These are the two examples of there are many other words which consists six letters. Okay, we can find later on if the time permits, we will discuss about the six letter words that we come in our lessons, in the coming lesson. Okay, now we will take the examples of seven letter word, which is the maximum letters in Arabic word. Okay, no word exceed the limit of seven letters. Like we have istighfar means asking forgiveness, and istifham, asking questions, interrogating. Okay, istifham means interrogating or to interrogate. La tatajawaz hadal adad. The kalima does not exceed seven letter limit. Keep in your mind. Istighfar, istifham are seven letter kalima, and kalima does not exceed the limit of seven letters. Kalima can be of one letter, two letter, three, four, and five, up to seven, not more than that. Got it? Now we will discuss about the types of kalima. Okay. We have taken the examples of kalima. Now we are going to discuss about the types of al-kalimatu. Al-kalimatu can be, al-kalimatu has three kinds. Al-ismu, okay. We will rub this board, we will write in a spacious form. Okay. Here we go. This is our first lesson, Al-Kalimatu wa Aqsamuha, Unit 3. Al-Kalimatu. Al-Kalimatu, which means word in Arabic. In English, it is called as word. It has three kinds in Arabic. Number one, al-ismu. Number two, al-fa'lu. And number three, al-harfu. Okay. Kalima, what is kalima? A group of letters which give meaning known as al-kalimatu. Minal hurufil hijaiyati tatarakkabul kalimat. From letters, kalimats are formed. Okay. And kalima can be of three types. Number one, al-ismu. Al-ismu has a broader sense in Arabic. Ism means noun, but in Arabic it covers noun, pronoun, adjective and adverb. Okay. Al-ism covers all these four topics of English. Okay. Al-ismu has a broader sense. Okay. Al-ism, what is the definition of al-ism? Al-ismu, it is every word by which we can name a person, a plant, a place, an animal, or a thing. Okay. Al-ismu, it is every word by which we can name a person, we can name a plant, we can name an animal, we can name an animal, we can name an inanimate object, immovable object, or we can name anything else. Al-ismu. Al-ismu has a broader concept in Arabic. It covers all the four topics of English, that is noun, pronoun, adjective and adverb. All these are covered by the single word al-ismu in Arabic. Got it? Now, come to al-fa'lu. Al-fa'lu, what is al-fa'lu? Al-fa'lu is an action word. Okay, as you have studied verb, it means verb. Al-Failu covers all types of verbs of English. For example, in English we have so many kinds of verbs like simple past, simple present, simple future. Past continuous, present continuous, future continuous. Past perfect, present perfect, future perfect. Past perfect continuous, present perfect continuous, future perfect continuous, imperative verb, negative imperative verb. All these verbs are covered by only one thing, that is al-failu in Arabic. Al-failu, verb. All the verbs are covered, all verbs. Okay, al-failu. What is the definition of al-failu? Al-failu means it is every word that signifies occurrence of an action. That signifies occurrence of an action at a particular time, known as al-failu. At a particular time means it may be a past, it may be a future, it may be a present tense. Al-failu, it denotes every action that took place or is taking place or will take place. Okay, in other words, it is every word which signifies the occurrence of an action at a particular time. Al-failu covers all the verbs of English. Okay, how many types of verbs? Nearly 12 kinds and many more verbs are there in English. Those all verbs are covered by only one thing, that is al-failu. We have types of words, types of fail as well. We will discuss in the later class. In the coming classes, we will discuss about the al-failu as well. Now come to the third type, al-harfu. Al-harfu literally means letter. But in Arabic, harf has a broader meaning. That is the reason we translate al-harfu as a particle. Particle means a part of a sentence. Okay. Particle covers all the remaining things except al-ismu and al-failu. The words which does not falls under the category al-ismu and al-failu, then that covers, that those words are covered by al-harfu. For example, al-harfu covers the articles. Al-harfu covers the articles. Al-harfu covers prepositions. Al-harfu covers conjunctions. And al-harfu cover interjections. Interjections. And so on, and other things which does not fall under the category of al-failu and al-ismu, then it will come under the category of al-harfu. These are the three kinds of kalima. We will take two examples for each of the type. For example, we have al-ismu. Al-ismu, like, it is anything. Al-ismu like qalam. Qalam, name of a thing, pen. And kitabun, it is also a name of a thing. Masjidun, name of a place. Okay, qalamun, name of a thing, kitabun, name of a thing, and masjidun, name of a place. Kalbun, name of a animal, dog. Hutun, name of a aquatic animal, fish. And al-failu, for example, kataba, he wrote. Qara'a, he read. And other examples like yaktubu, he is writing, or he will write. Though both the translations are done in this one word, yaktub. He is writing or he will write. Kataba, he wrote. Qara'a, he read. and yaktubu, he is writing or he will write, he writes, and yaqra'u, yaqra'u means he is reading, he reads or he will read. Three translations are done in this one word. As far as the al-harfu is concerned, we can take the example of ala, on, ila, to, fi, in, kaifa, how. Here interrogative words are also covered by al-harf, interrogatives. Okay. Here, now what is the definition of al-harfu? Al-harf has a broader meaning, like it covers all these types in English. But al-harfu, the definition of al-harfu is, it is every word whose meaning is not clear. It is every word whose meaning is not clear till it joins with other words, till it combines with other words, then it will give its clear meaning. For example, ala, on, ila, to, fi, in, kaifa, how, ayu, which, and so on, etc. Got it? With this, we will stop here. Inshallah, in our next class, we will take the definitions and examples of this Al-Kalimatu Aqsamuha. Then we will proceed towards the next topic, if Allah wishes. With this, we will close our class. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.